Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. It all depends from where you're watching us from. It is always a delight to come onto your screen and to have conversations that are uplifting, encouraging, and inspiring. And I pray that so far there has been a word for you that has been used to build you up and to encourage you and to call you up to arise and shine. Because that is why we are here. That is our mandate. And that is the calling that we have, to inspire you to arise and shine and become everything that God has put inside of you, to manifest all the goodness that God has put inside of you. But today, we are privileged to come to your screen once again and have a special show. This show, we are dedicating it to a special person. She is an angel right now watching over us, and we thank God for her life and for the gift that she was into our lives, for those that were able to interact with her on a personal level. She was such a gift. She had such a smile. She had such a spirit. She had such a heart for people. There was never a moment that you called on her because of someone in need that she took time to think about it. She always asked, "What can we do? When can we do it?" And this person is none other but Josephine Mwaniki. This was such a lovely woman. To me, she was like a mother. I called her mama. And to many, she was a mother. To many, she was a friend, a sister, a daughter. And today, we just want to dedicate this episode to celebrating her life, to remembering her in the best ways possible. Because at some point, she was to come to this show live and we were to have a session with her. But since God had taken her home, we cannot do it any other way but just celebrate her. And with me to do this is Pastor Miriam. Karibu sana, Pastor Miriam.
Thank you. Thank you, Helen.
So Pastor Miriam today is going to give us the journey of Josephine. Why? Because Pastor Miriam has walked a very special journey with Josephine. Josephine, apart from being a friend and a mother, to me, she is a part of the women that we congregate and we call ourselves the Deborah Generation. We have a community of women that we call ourselves the Deborah Generation. And if you want to join that community, you're most welcome. Just send a message and we will plug you in. But over and above that, this was your teacher. This was your friend. Mm-hmm. This was your confidant. Was somebody who walked you down the aisle when you were getting married. The relationship that you have was so beautiful and so special that you are the best person that can shine on some more light, and we can journey with to celebrate Josephine. Mm-hmm. Please tell us about who Josephine was and who she was to you.
Maybe I begin by saying who she was to me.
Yes.
Yeah, Josephine, she was so many things. That's what I'm able to say. Mm. One, she was my teacher. And this has surprised so many people who heard that Josephine was my teacher. Mm. And wondering, how did it be? Get to be that you had a teacher who became so close to you, became your friend, walked with you in a long journey, like 30 plus years now. Mm. And we met when I was a student in Giriabu Girls High School.
Yes.
I think precisely in 1990 when she came for her teaching practice from Kenyatta University. Mm. And she came in and vibrantly got to get into the Christian Union and worked with us and related so closely with us. Mm-hmm. By then, I was the Christian Union secretary. And so somehow we were meant just to board. And so after she did practicals, teaching practice, she went back cleared university and was posted to the same school. And so when she came back, we were able to get into one another, like have a friendship. And we continued with education and matters of the Christian Union. And then I think at some point, my mother had been sick. My own mother had been sick for a while. She had diabetes. And when I was in Form 4, she became a little more ill. And you know, now when you're in you're in fourth form, you all you're thinking about is books. And much of the time you spend is working to see that you do very well in your exam.
Yes.
And so that year, my mother got so unwell. And in June 1991, she passed on when I was still in school. And now you know what happens if you lose some relative, they call you home. And the principal then, late Mrs. Midhamo, called me to her office in an afternoon, on a Monday afternoon, and told me, I have to send you home. And I'm like, why? And she said, no, you just go. Don't you worry. All is going to be well. And so I went home. But before I could go home, as I'm coming back to class to see what I need to pick, I found her. We used to call her Miss Mwaniki. And so she asked me, where are you going? I told her, I've been told to go home. And asked me why. I told her, I don't know. And so I left and went home. And then in the course of that week, before my mother could be laid to rest on a Friday, I saw her come with a friend, with a family friend whose home is near our home. So I just saw her come. There were no phones then. You could not even write a message or communicate. It would only have to be like you move or you go to some town and make those booth things.
Yes.
And then you wait for them to pick on the other side and then you communicate.
Yes.
But she came looking for our home.
Wow.
And I think that became another pointer. For me, that became a game changer. It looked like, oh, this person treasures me this big. And then she went back to school and they she organized with the school on how they would come for the burial. And you see now, to me, she's the whole picture now turned to her. It's like she was the one planning everything. And that made my heart like her very much. And even after I went back to school, after my mom's burial, she was there. Anytime I looked low or I had moments I could not really understand what was going on in my mind, she always came in for me. I remember one day I broke down in class and I went to the dormitory and she came look. I don't know who told her that Miriam is, she went crying and she's in the dormitory. And she came for me. She took me to her house and made tea for me, ensured I was comfortable. Then we had some moment. She embraced me, told me, I am sorry, but I'll always be there for you.
Wow.
It's just going to be for a moment. And then she took me back to the dormitory. And because now, you see, I can't stay in her house. And but she kept following me so closely until I was able to do my exams.
Wow.
And then I went home. And even after I finished high school, we were in great contact. We kept meeting. We kept looking for each other. Every opportunity that arose and we were able to meet, we met. I would go to her house in school. Sometimes I would even go and she's not there and I find she's kept everything for me. And she would tell me I'll be coming back, but be staying meanwhile. And so it became like this person became a mother to me. And so we walked a journey. And there were so many things we were doing together. And so even when I decided I'm going to say, yes, I do, I took my friend to her. By that time, she was married. And I took my friend to her and she received him very well. And I told her, you know what? I know no other person. This is why I brought this man to you. And so she walked with me. She was my best lady together with her husband. I know people may be asking questions. She had been married. The rest is history. And so she became such a mother to me.
Yeah.
And even when we kind of, you know, sometimes in life you move your way and the other person goes their way.
Yes.
We were able to get
always
back.
Reconnect.
Whichever way we were able to just find each other.
Wow.
Until now, when we came to Nairobi, my family, my husband and I and our children in 2012, and somehow we were able now to reconnect so strongly and get to ask one another, where are you in life? We found a few things had changed about her and her relationships, and we embraced her.
Yeah.
She had been challenged and she was feeling like life wasn't really working very well on her.
Mm.
And we embraced her. We walked with her. We found time to just be together.
Mm.
Until now, she felt like, oh, I have people around me. And so we were able to share so much and encourage her to continue doing the good things she knows how to do. And at some point, after we have talked all those things, we later now, my husband and I began to do ministry in 2015, and she learned about it, and she asked if she could support, and we said, if you can, please feel free, and she came in and supported, and then said, no, I don't think I want to support from outside, and said, I want to be part of this. Because I feel like this is where God is.
Yes.
And I feel like you're doing the right thing, considering how I know you people.
Mm.
And so she came to church with her children and became one of us.
Wow.
And she touched lives. She did things. I'm telling you, that woman touched lives.
Wow.
Young couples, children, school-going boys and girls, anyone, old women. Anybody who had some issue, she would always ask, like you said, how can we help and when, you know?
Yes.
She would not stop at anything.
Mm.
I remember one time on a Sunday, she came to church and we had a young lady who had gone through CS and she had a child and a baby.
Mm.
And then the husband had been challenged and I don't remember, he was not able to provide for the family. Now you see, the woman has just come healing a wound. The man is not able to provide. And someone told us, Pastor, you know, so and so has needs. And when I told her, oh, she asked me, what is she telling you? And I said, oh, they are telling me this and this. And she asked me, what can we do? And she had some money she wanted to shop for her family. She told me, let's go shop. We went to shop. We bought things. We bought flour. We bought rice. We bought sugar. We bought soap. We bought tissue papers. We bought
all the supplies.
Like, and she's not even thinking about the budget she had for her family. Then we went to that family and we got in. And the girl saw us carrying things. And she just started crying.
Oh, my.
And then we talked and she opened up about the challenge that was there. And we assured her that we would do anything. And she kept checking. And anytime she was able to do something, she could.
She followed up.
She followed.
It was
she
not followed. Just about something that she just wanted to do and get away.
No, no, no.
From it. She had that heart to follow through.
She followed
to understand, are you okay?
Yeah.
Where are we at?
Yeah.
Like, she was really intentional.
Yes.
With her engagements with people.
Yes.
When she wanted to become the one who God would use to uplift you in a situation, she would be so intentional about that.
That's it.
And not just say, ah, wacha tufanye tu hii tu ende. But she would, even after that, she would
followed.
Really be concerned to
she followed
up.
It up.
Yeah.
And, you know, she was also a trained counselor, apart from a teacher, then a human resource manager. You know, she had qualifications and she was dumped. Yes. She wasn't just the Kenyatta University graduate.
No.
She went up and did a master's in human resource management.
Yes.
And she also did that course in in counseling.
In counseling,
yes. You know, even at some point when still in Giriabu Girls, she did theological education by wow. extension.
Wow.
So this woman was sharpening her blades. She had so many blades and she kept sharpening them.
She was a smart woman. Yeah.
And she was able also to associate with all calibers, all classes.
Well, that is another
every other level. Gift, yes. Yeah. She if children came, she's in.
She was
yeah.
into them.
When the teenagers come,
they would
when the learned youth come. Anybody, the young mothers, the old, anybody, the professors, the president.
Yes.
She was an all-rounded person who was able to relate with all forms of people
yes.
without offending or being offended. That was one thing I treasured about her.
That was really special.
And if you took her to the slums, there you go.
Yeah.
She's home.
Yeah. Yeah.
Take her to big places.
Yeah.
She'll know how to get into it and yeah. do everything that yeah. needed to be done.
Yeah.
So we have lost a person of great, I don't know what to call it, great, wow, I don't know which word to use.
Great impact.
Yeah, because great impact.
I can say, I will not say that we've journeyed with her for a long time because I actually... You are the one that got us,
mm-hmm.
put us together and
yeah.
became friends mm-hmm. and the family even appointed Helen to be the prayer pillar.
Yeah, and you have to continue.
For Josephine.
Mm.
And I remember every conversations that we were having were so rich.
Mm-hmm.
Like it was not... self-centered, you know, you would go even when her body was really frail and you're going and you are scared and you're like in your mind you're having battles, you don't know even how to react or around that situation, and her body is looking very weak but her voice is so strong and she's like why are you looking downcasted? We are going to win this.
Mm. Yeah,
we are victorious. Mm. And she's speaking such great things. She's inspiring you. And you're looking at the person who is talking and the voice that is talking. And in your mind, you're battling with that. Who is this woman?
Yeah.
And a very special, I will never forget this in my lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
This time that we had gone to see her in hospital.
Mm-hmm.
And across her, there was this woman who had just come out of surgery. They had amputated her leg.
Mm-hmm.
And her sister, Mary,
mm-hmm.
Sister to Josephine, mm-hmm. runs a foundation for... Mm-hmm. She had an accident.
Mm-hmm.
And now Josephine helped her start off a foundation that supports the disabled or the abled differently.
Yeah.
That is run by Mary.
Mm-hmm.
Now... Here she is in bed, not even able to move by herself, but she's concerned about this woman who has just come out of surgery.
Mm.
Her leg has been amputated, and she's thinking, how can I connect her to my sister so that by the time she's being discharged, she at least has a wheelchair and she has a support system that she's able to restart and rebuild her life.
Yeah.
Regardless of what has now happened that will change her life forever. And I'm thinking, wow, what a heart.
That's
what
it.
A gift you that's are. It.
That is it.
And this woman, even when we just laid her to rest the other week, and people who turned up from primary school, and I'm thinking, who still has connections of primary school? And it's like the entire class of women now in different, but they came, they traveled from all over just to come and send off somebody who really touched their life. Some spoke about her organization, how an organized person she was, how that impacted their life, that they have now become organized. Some talked about how neat she was,
and she was,
and how that impacted like this woman. Everything about her life made an impact. It was not only for her,
No.
It was something that she passed it on to.
Yeah.
Regardless of how little it may seem to be, but she passed it on to the other and the other. And actually, there is a testament of people's life saying, my life was a mess in this area. But because of Josephine, she taught me how to.
Yeah, I know, like the one who talked on behalf of the KU alumni.
Yeah.
I know her also. And that was like copy-paste, you know, like impact.
Mm.
The impact, like you transfer, you transfer money from one account to the other. And the Kahuhia team, you remember?
Yes,
that is
yes.
The big team that was there.
Oh, yes.
And they really talked well about her.
Mm.
In fact, I said, man, we are laying a soldier down.
Oh, yes.
It's like this woman's, you know, like we read in the Bible, that if because of the faith of Abraham, he speaks even when he's dead.
Yes.
And I'm waking up every morning these days and remembering the many moments we had.
Mm.
We had moments. We had moments where we would go shopping for clothes.
Mm.
We had moments where we would say, we've not had lunch for some time. Please come over. I would go to her office in some place in town and we'd go have our lunch. Or if she's busy, I would go in the evening. We would have our dinner and we would talk our things and then we would come home. There are those moments when we would go shopping for many other things. And it's like, it was like a training for me. It was like lessons. It was like when we have lunch, let's eat well. Let's enjoy life. Let's spend what we have earned on ourselves. Nobody else is going to tell us, celebrate yourself. When we went shopping for clothes, a whole day we would go, choose this, choose that, choose the other one. And she would say, no, it's time to treat ourselves well. And this journey, it's like I'm thinking, oh, was she telling me something?
She impacted me so much
and telling me, treat yourself well, celebrate yourself. And she did celebrate herself. The other bit is, though she celebrated herself, she was very careful with her spending.
Yes.
Yeah. Though she was good at giving, because she wouldn't leave you wallowing in problems. She was very good at saving.
Yes.
She was very good at investing.
Investment, yes.
Yeah, you know that.
Yes.
Yeah, she has left a legacy.
Yes.
She has done things that many of us, when we look at them, we are like, how did she manage to do all this?
And I remember one statement, one time I had gone to see her at home, and when we were talking about Deborah Generation and the vision about Deborah Generation, and she was saying, you know what, Helen? It's about time the woman understands that she has everything that she needs to, she needs within herself to become all that she wants to become. And whatever it is that you're doing, you need to make women arise.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah, that I know that whatever it is that you're doing, there's so much that I can learn from. And that also really was something else about her that, even with all her achievements, even with all her titles, even she was like, she would have those moments when she would sit down and she's listening and listening and then end up saying, wow, I want to learn what it is that you are doing.
Yeah.
Even from the simplest, from the smallest of them all, she was always ready to learn from the other person. She was not this person of, I've got it, I know it all. She was that person who would listen and who would want to learn and find a space, even if it's ile chini tu ya kuandika idea and share with you. If that was the part that she was to play, she was good with it as much as she was playing a part in impacting a life.
She was learning all the time. And you can understand because, like, when she came to church, she had her Bible.
Mm.
Not the phone, the Bible. and a notebook and a pen all the time. If she didn't have a pen for some reason, she would say, give me a pen. She would always be writing. That is to tell you she was always willing to learn. The other good thing about is her was team playing, team building. In fact, even in the office, the work they would give her, like the wellness clubs, that was like she was good in making team. I even remember one time that she was unwell at home and they kept calling. They were planning a team building day.
Yes.
And it's like, oh, you must come. And because she was just talking normally and they don't know how she is physically.
Yes.
They're like, oh, you must come. And she's insisting, you people, how should I talk so that, you know, I can't come. You know, she was so energized.
Yes.
Until you're like, oh. We are still moving on.
Mm.
And her demise just caught us like, oh, how? You know, like something we did not really want to see coming.
Yes, yes.
Because she looked, she was strong all the way.
She kept on, we are never giving up.
Yeah, she kept hope alive.
Yes, keeping
she
hope alive.
She held on and she made us to hold on to hope until God took her home. And we celebrate her, and we also thank God so much for the time that he allowed us to live and walk with her and learn from her.
Yes.
Yes.
And that is what we keep on encouraging the woman here on this platform, that look beyond yourself, look beyond your limitations, look beyond your challenges, look beyond the... You know, sometimes life throws some tests.
Yeah.
To us, it could be sickness, it could be you have a challenge with your child, it could be you have a challenge with your business or your job, but look beyond that and look within and see the greatness that God has put inside of you and start that journey of becoming and being intentional about life and deciding that I am going to live a life of impact. If there is anything that has come out of the life of Josephine, even as we remember her and celebrate her, is that she was so intentional and so impactful in all her life, in the journeys, in the different relationships that she had. Every person that came into contact with her, they can attest, they give a testimony that this woman made a transformation in my life or in an area in my life. And this is what we have always kept on saying, that you need to arise, you need to start moving, you need to start to begin from where you are. Stop having a pity party, stop feeling woe for yourself and understand that when you are not here, what will we say about you when you are not here? Will we forget you immediately we have laid you to rest? Or will there be something in our life that we'll be looking at and saying, oh, when I look at this, I remember so and so. And therefore, it is my prayer that we all reflect on self and ask ourselves, what will I be leaving behind when I have long gone to my Maker? And our prayer to the family is that may God keep on comforting you. May the peace of God reign on you, Phoebe and Dennis. You are Mama's children that she loved so much. And I know that she has left you on stable ground. And she has taught you so many things, so many wisdom, so much wisdom that she has impacted in you, that I know you, with the support system around you, that you're going to also leave a legacy just like Mama has left. And therefore we say, rest well with the angel Mama. We will always remember you because you have left a piece of your life with each and every one of us that had the privilege and the blessing to be a part of yours. Thank you so much, and God bless you. Till next time.